In this illustration, we'll discuss about impulse by a colliding particle on a rod. In this situation, we are given that a small particle of mass m moving horizontally on a smooth surface collides elastically with a uniform rod of mass 2m and length l, we can see in the figure, at a point d in the direction normal to the length of rod. Given that CD is equals to small d, and we are required to find the impulse imparted by particle on rod, and also we are required to find the speeds of ball and rod. So in this situation here, we can see as the particle is colliding and the rod is free to move, here about the center of mass of this rod or a point which is on table or on a smooth surface on which the whole system is placed, we can conserve angular momentum, and as no external force is present, linear momentum can also be conserved. And given that collision is elastic, so we'll also make use of a coefficient of restitution for ease in calculations. So here in solution, we can start with using conservation of angular momentum about C. Here we can write we have about point C, which is there on the ground. We can consider a situation, this is the given state which is before collision, and if we draw the state after collision, we can see if this is the rod, and after collision, say the ball will experience an impulse J backward, and it will impart an impulse J forward on the rod, due to which, say, the rod starts moving with a speed V1, and due to the angular impulse of this J, rod will attain an angular speed, and say ball's speed, which was initially U with which it was coming, after collision its speed changes to V. Say if this is the state which is after collision. So after collision, for the whole system, we can conserve angular momentum. So we can write the initial angular momentum about C was MUD, that is only that of the ball because the rod was at rest. And after collision, ball and rod both were having angular momentum. So here we can write for ball, it is MVD, as final speed of ball I have taken as V. For rod, as it is rotating about center, so we write it I omega, so its moment of inertia will be 2m L square by 12 multiplied by omega. Say this is our first equation, and we can write by linear momentum conservation, here we can directly write the initial momentum was mu, and final momentum will be mv plus 2mv1. This is your second equation we are getting, and we can write as e is equals to 1 because collision is elastic in this situation. So here we are using e is equals to 1. So we can write the coefficient of restitution equation as the approach velocity in this case is u, and after collision the separation velocity can be given as for the point on rod it is moving with velocity v1 plus d omega because the separation is given to us as d. So here there's v1 plus d omega minus v, so there's v1 plus d omega minus v, that's our third equation. And from these three equations, we can solve for the values of V, V1 and omega. So here we can write from equations, if we just have a look here, the mass can be cancelled. So here we are getting the value of U is V plus V1, and here we are getting U as V1 plus d omega minus V. So if we rearrange these two equations to eliminate the value of u, this will be v plus v1 can be equated to v1 plus d omega minus v, So we are able to relate these equations to get the value of v1 and u. One by one we can solve, like here in 2 and 3, from 2 and 3 we get, in the situation from these values we are getting, if we just add up these equations and eliminate the value of v, this gives us 2u is equals to 3v1 plus d omega. Say this is our equation 4. And we can also get a value, a relation between u and v, if we eliminate the value of v1. So if we eliminate the value of v1, it can be given as using 2 into 3 minus 2. See what this will result. This will be 2u minus u is u is equal to this 2v1 minus 2v1 gets cancelled out. This 2d omega minus this will be minus 2v minus v is 3v. So this giving us a value here, v is equals to 2d omega minus u by 3. Say this is our equation 5. Now we can write from equation 5 and 1. We just substitute the value of v from here to here. See what we are getting. Here m gets cancelled out. And we are having ud is equals to vd, where v is already given to us. This is 2 by 3 d square omega minus 1 by 3 ud plus this 1 by 6 l square omega. If we simplify this relation, we are getting the value of omega from here. The value of omega we are getting is 8 ud by l square plus 4 d square. So we are required to find the speeds of ball and rod. So this is the angular speed of rod which we have obtained, can be taken as one answer. And if we substitute the value of omega over here, we can write now in continuation from 5, the value of v we are getting is 2 by 3 d. Omega we substitute as 8 ud by l square plus 4 d square minus 1 by 3 u. Then on simplifying this value, we are getting the value of v as 1 by 3 u multiplied by 12 d square minus l square divided by 4 d square plus l square. So this is another result of the problem. For v, we are getting the final speed of ball. And if we calculate the final speed of rod, that can be obtained either from equation 2 or we can obtain it from equation 4. So we can write from equation 4, we get the value of v1 as 1 by 3 times 2u minus d omega. So here you can substitute the value of omega which we obtained from here. So on substituting the value of omega, just for a lack of a space, I'm substituting and then verify. You can verify the result. I'm directly writing it. It is given as 2u l square divided by thrice of 4 d square plus l square. That's the result of this problem for the final velocity of rod after collision. And last, if you wish to calculate the impulse imparted by rod, then here we can calculate the impulse J as it is the change in momentum of ball or that of rod. So for ball we can directly use J can be given as M times U minus V. And here the value of V you can substitute and verify the result. Finally you'll be getting is 4MU L square divided by thrice of 4 d square plus l square. That is the result of this problem. That is the way how we have analyzed, and mainly we have used linear and angular momentum conservation, and we have made use of the coefficient of restitution in this case.